All right, we are live. We are live, and I'm coming for five. I couldn't think of nothing else, guys. What's going on? This is not really a funny matter, so let me just start off by saying thank you all for the new subscribers that have come to the radio channel, to our channel, YouTube channel, my channel, GBoo2786. I'm Gavin Richard. Welcome to Gavin Richard Presents. Let's get some viewers in here for a minute. I'm trying not to make this a long video, but I did want to comment on this matter that has been going on in the news recently over the weekend. Of course, in my adopted city, my second home of Baton Rouge, Louisiana, we lost Miss Sadie Roberts-Joseph. Miss Joseph was a community activist. I never met Miss Joseph, by the way, Mrs. Joseph, but you know, I knew of the things that she did. I think we've maybe met in passing before, but Mrs. Joseph actually was the organizer of the Juneteenth celebrations that I would hear all on the radio, especially this past this summer. She would sponsor and organize all the celebrations that were going on. Of course, they would play the announcements on Q106.5, which is the leading Baton Rouge R&B station out there. So, you know, join us for Juneteenth celebration. I know that she was the one that was pushing all of that. So, you know, very tragic situation. Miss Joseph was only 75 years old, and she was wrongfully taken from us, you know, I would say too soon, and the way that she died, which is even worse. Of course, Miss Joseph, back in 2001, founded Black History History Museum, known as the Odell Williams Now and Then African American Museum. And, you know, at that museum, you got to actually see a bus to a bus from back in the 1950s during the segregation era that Miss Joseph obviously had lived in. And coincidentally enough, she actually lived in an area known as Scottonville, which is a few miles north of the metropolitan area of Baton Rouge. And the museum was on South Boulevard, which is downtown in Baton Rouge, or not far from Beauregard Town and so forth, but basically in the downtown area, which is on the outskirts of the predominantly Black neighborhoods and areas. Now, of course, like Baton Rouge, and I lived in Baton Rouge for almost 12 years, like any other city, even New Orleans, you have a tale of two cities, one Black, one white, one poor, one rich. One area developed and one not so developed. Scottonville, you know, is the home of, or North Baton Rouge is home of Southern University, my school, my alumni. And, you know, of course, when you go downtown, especially down Highland, you know, you get closer to LSU, that's the other part of the city, and, you know, the area where I lived in, which is South Baton Rouge, that was the area that was, you know, mostly developed. It was full of resources, whereas in North Baton Rouge, you had an area that was greatly underdeveloped and had sections of poor people. But you had a strong sense of community there. And I lived there actually for about a year. When I was on campus at Southern, and when I lived in the apartments, about 2 years actually. So I was back and forth, and just being at school for the next 2-3 years was, you know, I was home. I felt welcome there, so I can't deny that. But of course, you have areas once again, and across the country that are like that, where a town or area will be underdeveloped and, you have some areas that are, you know, there's no malls, no markets. You have to go shop in a certain part. And even in New Orleans, we have that. New Orleans, by the way, is the only metropolitan city that does not have a shopping mall. I don't know that I know of. I don't know anywhere else. But as far as being a major city, and all the shopping malls are outside in different parishes, like Jefferson. On both across the river, there's this Oakwood shopping mall, but and then across the 17th Street Canal, you have the Clearview Mall, and you have the Lakeside Shopping Mall, but that's all in Jefferson Parish. And even in Chalmette, they have a shopping center as well. Let me try and get some more people to come in if you're just joining me. Let's see. Who's in the chat room? Do we have anybody? No, I'm about to put this on here. Hold on a second, guys. Just trying to get some more people to join in. So, there we go. So, an arrest. So, getting back to it, those that don't know, an arrest was just recently made in Mrs. Joseph's death. That is the breaking news. And the suspect is a gentleman who is a registered sex offender by the name of Ronald Bell. Ronald Bell, according to the police report that I have here that I'm reading, Mr. Bell, 38 years old, is a registered sex offender. Now, as a general rule, and you guys know this, being an attorney, when I talk about these things, I always state that a person is always presumed innocent until proven guilty. I don't know if Mr. Bell is truly the one that killed Miss Joseph. I don't know that for a fact. And I believe in due process. I believe that a person is presumed innocent until proven guilty. I don't believe in lynch mobs. You know, especially when something tragic happens, we all want to rush to judgment. We all want to rush and catch who did it because we're upset at what happened. But I like to take my time and see what the facts and evidence is. And he has been not been proven guilty as of yet. So he is innocent. However, it is disturbing what the allegations are. I can't deny that. And what this gentleman is accused of, Mr. Bell, he's been booked with first-degree murder. He was initially booked as a fugitive Monday night after he failed to pay a fee related to his sex offender registration. That's the worst crime you can actually be convicted of, because if you're a sex offender, people will forgive a murderer quicker than they will forgive a sex offender. Like, that's something that's almost unforgivable. When we hear stories, of course, now with the Me Too movement, you know, you get accused of sexual harassment, just sexual harassment alone, that haunts you for the rest of your life. If you get accused of sexual assault, you know, people are not forgiving of that, especially the feminists in the country who, you know, are very adamant and want blood when they try to push, you know, their agendas and their goals. Now, getting back on subject, the police confirm, and this is a report on WAFB. I will put that link in the chat box. I'll also try later on edit and put it in the box for my feed, or my information box, excuse me, guys. It says here, Ronnie Bell, the 2000 was confirmed, was renting space in a property owned by Mrs. Joseph, and said it's believed he killed her because he owed more than $1,200 in back rent. Huh. It is unclear if Roberts Joseph was ever aware of Bell's criminal background. So whether she knew about it. And keep in mind, when you are a sex offender, whenever you move, you have to notify the state and your neighbors that you're a registered sex offender and what your crimes are and what you were accused of doing. You have to do that. So they're stating, I guess, the motive for killing Ms. Joseph was over back rent, which is, if he did so, this is outright foolish. 2007 report from the advocate says Bell pleaded guilty to the sexual battery of a 9-year-old. Instead of facing a potential life sentence for aggravated rape, his plea deal allowed him to get out of prison after 7 years A vigil is planned for Tuesday night at the Odell S. Williams Now and Then Museum of African American History, which she founded in 2001. So just think how quick the police are to not only make an arrest, but to now come up with a motive as to why Ms. Joseph was murdered, an alleged motive, again, because I don't know all the facts of the case, but they're stating that this guy, and here's a link to the African American Museum as well, I'm going to put in the chat box. Hold on a second. Whoever's in the room watching, chat in the box, tell me what you think about what's going on, man. Yeah, it's crazy what's just happened to Miss Joseph. We just had the Juneteenth celebration in Baton Rouge. So my thoughts and my prayers are with her and her family. You certainly don't like to see any life be taken away like this, and especially if it was over $1,200. I mean, good God, man, you don't kill someone over that. Now, I mean, for something minute and, you know, small like that, that you owe, nonetheless, that's something you can fight in court if you chose to. But, you know, and I don't know, maybe he didn't want to go back to court because he probably was going to jail for failing to notify or pay his fee. I don't know that, though. He's innocent until proven guilty. So let him have his day in court. It's shocking and sad that this has happened to her and to her family. And, you know, again, my thoughts and prayers are with her, our community in Baton Rouge. She was quite a leader. You know, the fact that she just up and started her own museum, that she wanted to show the world, to show to community in Baton Rouge, to have a knowledge of history, you know, one of few, because I don't know too many. There are some African-American museums around, but, you know, I know the nearest one that I can think of, there was one in New Orleans out here off of, I think it was off of Claymore, if I'm not mistaken, right under the overpass where I used to go to. But it was an art museum, so it actually, I don't know if it's still up and running, I think it is. But I remember a small place. But nevertheless, the fact that she did that for her people in Baton Rouge and so forth, the Juneteenth celebrations that she organized, people, she was well-liked and admired. And even the police department and the district attorney's office was trying to get anybody to comment and come forward if they had any information. And you know, guys, coming forward and speaking of police with that, I also wanted to do a video of some information that I learned and with regards to the death of Nipsey Hussle. They've released a report yesterday that Nipsey was under police surveillance, which, oh, doesn't shock me because Nipsey's own brother had stated at the funeral that the city was having issues with them being in the area. Nipsey's brother, Black Sam, he talked about it and how at the funeral, remember when he was eulogizing Nipsey, he stated how they wanted to evict them and the owners liked them so much they actually gave them their space for free, you know, because they never had problems, they paid their rent on time. And you couple that with the fact that the woman who was getaway driver for Nipsey's alleged killer and his killer was, I have his name,
okay guys, so check this out. No, in an effort article. To skip a preliminary hearing, a grand jury has reportedly indicted alleged Nipsey Hussle killer.
That's who it was. Yeah, I think about the attorney general, his name slipped for now on me. But yeah, he was recently indicted back on May 22nd, according to this article. You know, he was, if everybody remembers, he was able to get back after shooting Nipsey. He drove off in an alley with this woman who, you know, dropped him off wherever. She claimed that she was held against her will and she went forward to the police. But of course, if you participate in a crime in any way, shape, or form, you know, you're considered an accessory either before or after the fact. So if she was the getaway driver and she had been there beforehand and she knew about it and planned it, and I don't know all the details of it, she is just as guilty as the man who pulled the trigger as a accessory before the fact to second-degree murder. Of course, now, if he randomly came up to her and put a gun to her head and she went ahead and still drove him off, she could still be charged with accessory after the fact. However, there was no intent behind it. If, you know, being forced against her will with threat of death, you know, of course she could probably get out of it. But still, the fact that she wasn't charged, that she came forward, was very suspicious to a lot of people, even myself. So couple that with the fact that a police report also not too long ago came out where they were investigating why this woman was not arrested, or why was she further questioned, and they were doing an internal investigation. It just goes to show you how much people trust the LAPD. There is very little trust among snakes. And the LAPD has had a history of cover-ups, from the O.J. Simpson case to corruption with the Rampart scandal and Rodney King, even the Biggie Smalls murder. Hell, even Robert F. Kennedy, if we're going to talk about even something of more significance, there was questions about the way that they handled that assassination. So I didn't want to talk about that, and I was trying to get them all done in two, but of course, with Miss Joseph, this new breaking news that came across my phone on courtesy of WBRZ Channel 2 News, an arrest was made in Miss Joseph's killing. You know, once again, you know, these men who, Eric Holder and Mr. Bell, Ron Bell, they are presumed innocent until proven guilty otherwise. But the allegations, of course, were as dastardly as they are. You know, he deserves due process, but an arrest has been made, and we will look into it further as to what happens and find out what goes on. But keep the family in prayers. You know, I think that they are going to, they definitely need it. Keep the city in prayers as well, because, you know, this is Baton Rouge, the same area where Alton Sterling was killed, same city. You know, I don't think it helps. I know it doesn't help, especially when you lose someone who was that loved, like Miss Joseph was. And I'm sorry, I will never get the chance to meet her, unfortunately. But I pray for her and her family, and hope for some closure for them if they ever find it. So, guys, that's it. That's all I wanted to talk about. I posted the articles here. Please follow me here on GBoot2786. We'll be back for another episode. Before I go, who are the two people in the chat room? Why don't you type something in the chat box? Tell me you're watching, so I'll know who you are. I'll shout you out. I'll try and put these articles in my info box too. So you guys take care. Nobody wants to talk. All right. Well, I got to get back to work, guys. I'll talk to y'all later. Peace.